Yes, children, a quick revision of electrochemistry. What is the difference between electrochemical cells and electrolytic cells? In electrochemical cells, chemical reaction is converted into electrical energy, whereas electrolytic cell, electricity, unless you pass through, a chemical reaction will not occur. Okay? Now, in an electrochemical cell, anode behaves as a negative electrode and cathode as a positive electrode. Whereas in an electrolytic cell, anode is positive, cathode is negative. Okay. Now this is common for both the cells. Oxidation will always take place at the anode and reduction will take place at the cathode. And the flow of electrons is from the anode to cathode in the case of both the cells. Okay. So this is the basic thing about electrochemical and electrolytic cell that you need to know. Now you have studied about an electrochemical cell, how it is constructed. You are having an anode and a cathode. You have an anode placed inside an aqueous solution of the given salt. Now here I have placed zinc rod in zinc sulfate solution, and on the cathode copper rod placed in copper sulfate solution. Okay, and there is a salt bridge connecting the two half cells. This is a half cell, this is a half cell. This is the salt bridge, which is generally made up of say a simple filter paper rolled and dipped into a saturated solution of potassium nitrate or potassium chloride generally, and it is, the ends are dipped into both the half cells. Okay, so here what happens when the anode reaction starts, that is oxidation, when it starts, zinc will start losing electrons and the electrons will go through the external circuit, and zinc 2 plus ions will go into solution. Okay, so there will be excess of zinc 2 plus here, and in this cathode what you'll find, Cu 2 plus ions from the solution will go towards Cu, get reduced there, so there will be deficiency of Cu 2 plus here, excess of zinc 2 plus here and deficiency of Cu 2 plus here. With the result, what will happen, there will be an electrical imbalance. And in order to manage the electrical imbalance, the salt bridge will function there. Since it is made up of KCl or KNO3, जहाँ पे जो deficiency है उसके हिसाब से वो पूरा होगा. जैसे यहाँ पे zinc 2 plus excess में है, तो NO3 minus will shift towards this position, towards this electrode. And here Cu2 plus की कमी है, तो K plus यहाँ पे जाएगा. So that's how electrical imbalance will be solved. Okay, so this is the basic idea about electrochemical cell. When the flow of electron is from the anode towards the cathode, this voltmeter which is connected will give you a reading which will tell you how much of electrical energy is produced in this particular cell. Now in case if the cell is not connected properly, then this voltmeter will not give a reading. In that case, what you have to do, जिसको आपने कैथोड बनाया है उसको एनोड बनाओ, एनोड को कैथोड बना के फिर चेक कर लो. इफ द वोल्ट मीटर वर्क, दैट मीन्स द रिएक्शन विल टेक प्लेस बिटवीन द टू. इफ देर इज नो वोल्ट मीटर रीडिंग, दैट मीन्स द एनोड एंड कैथोड रिएक्शन दैट यू हैव चोजन इज रॉन्ग, इट विल नॉट वर्क. ओके, नाउ बेस्ड ऑन द ई नॉट वैल्यूज, इफ E naught is negative, जैसे zinc 2 plus bar zinc is negative. So what does it show? This shows that zinc 2 plus does not readily reduce to zinc. That means zinc to zinc 2 plus is more spontaneous. Negative E naught cell tells you that that particular reaction is not spontaneous. Okay. Same way, look here. Cu 2 plus to Cu is plus 0.34. This shows that reduction of Cu 2 plus to Cu is spontaneous. Okay. So if the E naught cell is, if the E naught electrode potential value for a particular electrode, if it is positive, that means that particular reaction is spontaneous. And if it is negative, that means this particular reaction is non-spontaneous, right? Okay. Now it is customary to use only the reduction potential values for all types of calculations. That is why we are using reduction potential here. Okay. So that's what I've written here. Reduction reaction is non-spontaneous, which shows that zinc to zinc 2 plus is spontaneous. That is, oxidation of zinc is spontaneous. Now here, reduction of Cu2 plus to Cu is spontaneous. So oxidation of Cu to Cu2 plus is non-spontaneous. Okay. So remember always, negative E0 value means non-spontaneous reaction. Positive E0 value means spontaneous reaction. Right? Okay. Now, what are the functions of salt bridge? To maintain electrical neutrality of the cell and to prevent mixing up of solutions in the two half cells. The solutions will not be mixed. That is, you will not find zinc sulfate moving to this cell or copper sulfate moving to this cell. Mixing up of solutions will be prevented, because when NO3 minus comes here because of excess zinc 2 plus, K plus cannot come here because already there are zinc 2 plus in excess. Okay, that zinc 2 plus will push the K plus up. So K plus will not come here. Okay, nor Cu2 plus can come here, right? Because it's already more positive charges here. Same way here, when you consider this side, K plus will go. Because Cu2 plus ki kami hai, tabhi K plus ja raha hai, theek hai? So that way, mixing up of solutions is not possible. Now, how do you represent a particular cell? It is the anode reaction separated by salt bridge, followed by cathode reaction. Anode, salt bridge, cathode. Anode, salt bridge, cathode. Okay, this is how you write the cell representation. Okay, and potential of individual half cell, it cannot be measured. And if you want to measure the potential of an unknown electrode, what you have to do is, you have to couple it with a standard hydrogen electrode whose potential has been arbitrarily fixed as zero. Okay, H plus bar H2 is zero. So from the voltmeter reading, we can find the E0 of unknown electrode, whatever the reading it is given, because the formula is E0 cell is equal to E0 cathode minus E0 anode. Supposing anode is hydrogen half cell and you do not know what is E0 of cathode, this will tell you, this is known to you, this is zero, so this you can calculate. Okay. Now that is about electrochemical cell. And then there can be questions like this: can you store copper sulfate solution in a zinc pot? Can you use a nickel spatula in zinc sulfate solution? Can you store copper sulfate in a silver vessel? Things like that. So in such a case, what you have to do is, you will find out the E0 cell for that particular reaction. Say for example, can you store Cu2 plus? In a zinc pot. Okay, that means CuSO4 plus zinc, you will make the, you will write the equation and you will find out the E0 cell for you. E0 cell is coming out to be 1.1. since E0 cell is positive, the reaction takes place. That means you cannot store copper sulfate in a zinc pot. This is what it shows. Okay, so in case this E0 cell comes out to be a negative quantity, then the reaction will not take place. That means you can store. Okay, so this is how you have to understand. So we have seen so many examples based on this. Okay, so I am not going into details of that. Same way, you will have to understand whether a particular ion is a good reducing agent, or a metal, good reducing agent, a good oxidizing agent. You can find out. How to find out? Standard E0 values are given to you. Strength of reducing agent increases from top to bottom. That is, low electrode potential, high reducing power. This I have already taught you in 11th class also. And strength of oxidizing agent increases from bottom to top. In the electrochemical series, you will find out in the, you will see in the book, the complete page. You will find from top to bottom, you will have the lowest value right at the top, and then slowly the values will increase. That is, reducing agent, strength of reducing agent increases, and strength of oxidizing agent increases from bottom to top. From niche se upar jaoge, to strength of oxidizing agent will increase. Right at the top, you will have F2 plus 2 electrons giving you 2F minus. Is that clear? So F2 is a very good oxidizing agent. So right at the top, what you find, they are very good oxidizing agents. Right at the bottom of the series, what you find, they are all very good reducing agents. Okay. So this is what you have to remember. Say for example, you have been given the E0 values, electropotential values for zinc and H+. Okay. Now from this, what you understand? This is having a negative value. If this is negative, what does it mean? This reaction does not take place. That means the opposite reaction takes place. That means zinc can easily lose electrons. That means zinc is a good reducing agent. Okay. And here this is zero. So zinc is a stronger reducing agent than hydrogen, because the more negative value, the more reducing power of the metal. Okay. And if it is positive, positive E0 means the redox couple is a weaker reducing agent than H+. Say for example, here you see Cu2+ is a good oxidizing agent. It's more oxidizing than H+, whereas Cu is a weaker reducing agent than H2. Okay, so this is what you have to understand.